Okay, you ready?
No.
Welcome to the Whiskey Vault. You ready?
Yeah.
No, that's not what you just said. You ready?
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely.
Today is a gift from Magnificent Bastard. Oh, wait, no. Yeah, is Lee Teague a Magnificent Bastard? Or is he a patron saint? Hang on. I gotta double check that. This is when Rex would be giving me shit for not having already remembered this. Find and replace.
How dare you?
I know. Four matches. That's a Magnificent Bastard.
Okay.
Okay, so you start with Lee Teague. You ready?
Lee Teague?
You magnificent bastard!
Do you want me to pick up the bottle every time?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Maryland Whiskey Company single cask bourbon.
Oh, another one!
I know.
Nice.
So, craft distilled, hand crafted, pot distilled, hand crafted. Batch 23, some or another barrel, it's all rubbed off and you can't tell.
Uh-huh.
So this is a distillery in Rockville. I was trying to remember. Rockville, Maryland. And they're like an urban distillery. They're like in town, not out in the country.
I like that color.
And they...
Ooh.
Whoa! I shouldn't talking before I smelled it. What did you get on that? That was like
grapefruit. Fast and just gone. It kind of reminded me of candy.
Yeah.
Like gummy candies, some kind of fruity gummy candy, like a lemon lime or...
I just got an explosion of grapefruit mixed with wood oil and furniture polish.
Yeah. I see the furniture polish.
And this is so candied fruity, but then there's this like cleaning solution medicinal note on the outside edges of it.
It reminds me of that. What's that stuff called? The pine sol?
Pine sol? Yeah.
A little bit like that.
Pledge.
Mm-hmm.
Lemon pledge.
Mm-hmm.
It's not lemon.
That candy note though.
Yeah, that is hard
first,
candy.
But for me, like the first nose, it was there and then gone.
Yeah.
And then it just kind of like settled out into what I'm getting now, which is the hard candy, but not as extreme.
It is flattening into something a little more approachable and not as dramatic on the nose. Now it's turning into like a really wood oily direction, classic bourbon note.
Yeah, definitely more barrel impact on this one than the other.
So much. So pot still.
Yeah.
Right, not column. Pot still bourbon, single cask, corn, rye, and barley, 15 gallon barrels.
I swear, every time it's sitting here, it looks like has a reddish tint to it.
It does, it's like cherry colored. This is Edgardo Zuniga. They're sourcing all their own grain. They're making everything themselves. He's from Costa Rica. And a lot of the other products they make are flavored. Like if you look at their product page, it's like 80% flavored direction type things.
Cool.
And then whiskey and, yeah.
Yeah, I would say that kind of hard, it's almost like a cherry Jolly Rancher, but not as punchy and sweet. It's just kind of like a...
Man, for a split second, I got pineapple.
Pineapple.
Yeah.
If you get past the barrel and spice, it is like a fruit bomb.
Yeah. Oh, whoa. And then another thing showed up, and it was cumin.
Hmm. Well, you're not wrong.
This is bizarre. You're not wrong. You're stealing my lines?
Yeah.
This is bizarre.
I could almost sit with this one for a while just to see how else it changes.
Yeah.
This is just interesting.
Okay, are you ready to taste it and see whether it doubles down on that complexity or whether it just gets like, bloom? It's 90 proof, so they proofed it down to 45. All right. Oh. Is that what you got too? It starts with all the wood oil and all the complexity, and then it just kind of waters into nut and thin air.
Yeah, the finish is really short.
And then I got no lingering. If there's any lingering, it's a little bit waxy.
Yeah.
Wood notes.
For me, a little grassy too.
But now it's gone.
Mm-hmm. That was really quick.
You know what it reminds me of? You ever chew gum where the flavor runs out really quickly? And then you're left with this like nasty flavorless, chewy thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it sort of reminds me of. Is that what juicy fruit does?
Juicy
I don't remember.
Fruit.
Yeah, it's that, like, oh, this is, well, it's gone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Huh. The nose, on the other hand.
It's really interesting. The nose is, it just changes.
Pineapple. Toasted pineapple.
Toasted pineapple?
Yeah, like when you ever get grilled pineapple wedges?
Yes.
Yeah. Smell that.
I love grilled pineapple.
Grilled pineapple.
So I could live in this nose.
Oh, it just
really
keeps going.
I like the nose on this one.
That's
I wonder
bizarre.
What it would do in a blend.
I wonder what it would do at cask. Ooh, yeah, I wonder what it would do in a blend. Oh, dominate, I'll bet. Maybe
but,
not, because
like,
it didn't feel oily.
The nose might contribute something, but maybe it just needs a little boost for the palate.
Well, it's 45. Maybe when you're blending, if you got the cask strength version, maybe the cask strength version actually holds on to all of those flavors.
Yeah.
Instead of letting them go into water.
I would be curious to try it cask strength. Even like 100.
Even just higher.
Yeah, just higher. See if it changed it. Because the palate was quick.
Okay. Comments.
All right, David.
Say it with drama. You read ahead, cheater. No reading ahead.
You did not explain that rule before. David Kiefer asks, actually it's a statement.
Oh, okay.
Rex, we need sleeveless shirts to see the guns better.
I like how you assumed that if there were sleeveless shirts, there would be guns.
Is this where we get to hassle Rex?
Yes, yeah, where we get to hassle Rex. You can't do anything about it, except for maybe jump into the comments or something.
Maybe,
but that's it.
Yeah.
The nerds are in charge now.
We are.
Yeah. I wonder what our vibe of the channel is now. Because before it was like very shenanigan heavy or tangent, story tangent heavy. Or rude jokes heavy.
Yeah, now it'll probably just be like
really boring
dad jokes.
Yeah. Oh.
And then
you know what's
me just like laughing at things that I think
are funny.
I'm funny.
But you're not telling.
But
you're
not
telling
really
anyone what they
that,
are.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not really that funny.
That's
lots
fair.
Of whiskey.
Yeah. Well.
Okay. You ready for the other question?
Yeah.
Eric Bertrand asks. It has been my impression that metallic, salty, meaty, smoky is the same flavor that presents differently on the spectrum as it ages. Would you agree?
Oh, interesting. How about, well, you speak to this. You're in charge of the barrel house. The umami notes.
Mm-hmm.
How does that alter an aging in your experience?
I feel like I would say yes and no. Like that's not a black and white response.
And try to answer it as asked first and then adjust it.
Yes and no.
Okay, so yes what?
Yes, I think that does happen with some barrels
it
and products.
Them,
like
right.
You can change that flavor in the same barrel as it gets older and older. And I'm trying to think of a specific example. Maybe seeing an ashy smoke transforming mm-hmm. over time.
Right.
It's not just one thing from the beginning to the end. Maybe it started off less ashy and then it exploded into a very heavy ash and then it turned into more like campfire. But when I'm thinking no, that's not the only case because I'm also thinking of different types of peat.
Yeah.
And so like an Islay peated scotch is going to be very smoky and briny in that smoke flavor. But Irish peat to me is way more forest-like and like dead leaves, like foliage
mm-hmm.
And like dried earth and that sort of smoke. And I don't think that's something changed as it aged on one spectrum. I think it's just you just had a different ingredient that contributed a different flavor.
I think so too, because several of these things he named, like metallic and smoky and meaty, I've had those three in the same whiskey as three distinct things.
Yes.
And so it's not the same thing that just becomes different as it gets older.
Yeah.
It's three different things.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there is in Lou Bryson's book, which you should get.
Yeah. Tasting Whiskey?
Yeah, it's brilliant. A thing over here with age on the bottom. And flavors on the side. And we have found this in our barrel house too, that when you first create something, you get all these kinds of patterns, or so you get these kinds of things where depending on the note, mm-hmm. it doesn't show up at all in the beginning, but over time, and this is like wood, for example, the tannins will climb, but then there's a point in which the wood is exhausted slightly and it'll start to soften into wood sugars. Or you get something where it's like at the beginning, you get those young barley grain notes that just dominate. And over time, they get softer and softer and softer. And so I think what you're talking about, some of these flavors, those are three different things. And over time, they will interact with each other.
Yeah.
Because what's weird is anytime you taste this whiskey, you're going to capture it at a point in time like this, right?
Yeah.
So early on, those flavors will present like that, but 2 years later, the same flavors will dominate in different order or vanish completely.
Mm-hmm. I do think things kind of like alter and change as they age.
Oh, and the one thing that its graph doesn't show that is only thing that's missing from that graph is sometimes these things combine into a whole new thing that has a starting point up here and then shows up.
Mm-hmm.
Right, but like you don't even get that until a certain time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like in our unpeated malt barrels, I don't know if I can share this. Can I talk about our whiskey?
Yeah, yeah, I can talk about our whiskey.
I can talk about our whiskey. Our unpeated malt barrels, really early on, there was a heavy, just like juicy fruit. No, I swear it tasted just like juicy fruit. And that's kind of aged out. Too. Like as those barrels have gotten older, I don't taste it nearly the same way I did when it was 6 months old versus a year old in baby barrels. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. I think there's a lot of grayscale in that question.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. These are nerd heavy fun episodes for me.
Good.
This nose, go back to that nose.
Now it's heavy caramel.
Yeah, heavy caramel and like that what Rex and I always describe as wicker.
Oh.
Like Pier 1 herbal wicker botanical things to make rooms smell better sticks, right?
Yeah, but not so but strong caramel candy. That it hurts your nose.
Right.
Some of those are
they do.
Super pungent.
They burn.
Yeah.
All right, here's to fighting, stealing, and drinking.
If you fight, may you fight for a friend.
If you steal, may you steal your lover's heart.
And if you drink, may you drink with us.
Wait, hang on. If you drink, may you drink with us. Give me a pause there. I can't keep up.
Okay.
Next time. Cheers.
Cheers.